So, the last, a year ago in Portland, when we did the round table, it like made this possible, all the work we've been doing in the last year, and I hope it's going to happen again, because it was really magic, just to say. Should we start? I don't know.
What time is it?
1 minute.
1 minute.
Choice later.
So Holger made some slides. So that's where we want to go.
Where are we now?
We're in the present. We want to go to the future.
No, we are here. That's the end of the hill.
So the other graph was the lie, and so I thought we'd make an even bigger lie to make it even look more fancy. That's where we want to go. Maybe not that fast, but...
So few package editions.
Yeah, that's right.
Less removal.
So we're basically, we wanted to make a list of what we had to discuss, but we failed because we wanted to make a good talk the past hour, and I think we did it, but this meant we can do, we could not do everything. Yeah.
But you can just put the Bobby on Bobby's of the box we had, yeah.
Yeah, or just put on the other presentation again.
Yeah, I can try to find that.
Yeah, that has the box.
Because the real blockers to get anything reproducible is to get these fixes in the D package, dev helper, and to build on the build is having to read on the path which the users can use, have that in S build, and have the FTP archive support built into files. These are the topics basically. And shall we start with the package?
Yeah.
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 Yay. Yay!
Should I start or? Okay. So one of the issues with the packages that I've mentioned in the list, for me the biggest blocker is that because currently the times on the R container is the only thing that kind of qualifies like in a way the build environment. For me, losing that information right now, where there's no replacement, is a showstopper. So as long as we don't have build, the build information or whatever is contained there in the archive, I'd rather not like make the R container or lose that data.
But if you would have these build info files, you would be fine.
Yes, because then that information is somewhere else.
Okay.
So I don't mind. I don't want to lose this information because right now, it's just a really like fuzzy approximation, but it's the best we've got now. So if you want to know when a package was built, you can check the timestamp on the binary, and you could infer. I mean, of course, it's really fuzzy and stuff, but you could infer from a snapshot what was the environment for that day. And of course, that means that the building for information is the kind of the critical part. For like everything else, because the tar reproducibility stuff and the other remaining things are things that affect only the binary package. So if one of them is not reproducible, the rest are unimportant. So it's either all of them or not. So as in like that, it doesn't make sense to, or it doesn't matter if they are in or not. I'm not sure if I explained myself.
Well, for I know that for Helmut, it was a problem to not have the file ordering patch because he can filter the timestamp issues, but the file ordering is much more complex to analyze.
Yes, yeah, I've actually.
It's a bit different, you know.
You're here,
so,
sorry.
The timestamp still is different, okay? There's two lines in the diff, but since I have to cut down and diff at like 1,000 lines, the top of the diff is polluted with all the ordering issues. And then I don't see the interesting bits, so getting the ordering right would make the diffs immediately much more useful.
Yeah, and in that sense, I've actually, I think I've talked with Chris and Holger that I got a patch locally that I've not tested properly or extensively, and I'd like to get it tested before I deploy it on dev, because it's not localized to the reproducible stuff, it affects the whole archive, and I'd rather not break Debian, so...
So we can test that.
Yes, so that's that was my point. I'll probably polish whatever it's missing, and I can send it to you guys, and if you could do a run over all the archive, at least that part I might find, I don't have an issue with that part.
So from these three bugs, there's two non-controversial ordering and the file permissions also, I guess?
The file permissions?
Normalized file permissions when creating control tar.
Yeah, I've not actually looked at the patch. It felt that there was something not completely right, but I have to check it out. But also coming back to the M time stuff, you mentioned on the talk, and we have discussed this on the list. I think there's been discussions. But if upstream is not amenable to have tar accept a clamping value for them times, something I want to do mid long term is to have an internal tar implementation for creating tar.
In detail.
Yes, because that will also allow us to have other features. So for me, that's on the origin, and that will mean that we don't have to care if tar upstream supports or not clamping. So this clamping could be done already on the package itself, and then it also means that we don't have to modify any package to do this find thingies on the file system. So
out of interest, what other features were you thinking unrelated to?
That will allow us to build packages without being root. So you can have a manifest, and then you can just specify the permissions and owners and everything.
So things should definitely capture that you feel that the AR end time issue blocks on build info.
Sorry, again?
We should capture that you think that the AR issue requires the build info things to be available.
Yeah,
a dependency between issues.
Yes, the M time thing is kind of definitely we can work around it in other places, but for me the blocking thing is build info on the R
prior lines.
The rest are not in just because if you don't have a fully reproducible package, it's just not useful anymore.
I'm just like Shimming was sorry.
So it sounds like this build info stuff is going to take a while to actually hit the archives. Would you accept a patch in the meantime to basically standardize the AR M time based on source date epoch?
Let's discuss the build info and before arriving to that conclusion, maybe.
So at least for build info, I have several concerns I've voiced before. One is that the path, embedding the build path, which for me it's a privacy issue, because it leaks information from your current system, and I don't really like that.
But binaries are leaking that information anyway from your...
Sure, but one of the points of reproducibility is that we want to to make things neutral and not expose time zone and all that stuff. I mean, that we currently have this problem doesn't mean that we have to make it worse. And if you are building binary packages on your system and you get a build info file where it lists your home path with all the username and
I would like to separate the paths in the build info file from the build info files themselves. Because the paths we also would need to discuss with the build maintainers where they build.
Yeah.
And we're talking about, soon we'll have build info files with some paths in there.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to discuss that first, and then come back to this privacy leak concern. My solution would be just a whitelisted file we agree on /paths, and then you put only that in the build info file if it's built in /paths. So that if people build in whatever, let's say they build in /build D, then you put it in there, because if you have a privacy leak information in /build D, it's your own fault.
Okay.
While if you build in home, Holger, MySQL project, you probably don't want to leak that.
Yeah.
So, and regarding the build info files, or should I explain this build info idea first?
That was one of my questions.
Yeah.
What exactly is in the build info file? Because all I've heard current up to date is
sounds like that is something that could go into the packages files as an extra field.
Yeah, that's
right. It does need on files for that.
The build info file at the moment has the build part, which we just discussed. It has the checksums of the source packages used. It has the checksums of all binaries created. And it has a list of the packages installed while building the package.
So that sounds pretty much like just extra fields in the packages files. Why do we need an extra file? That makes the handling much easier on our side.
A source package. No, it's the binary package. The information is per source package. But you would repeat then the information. It needs to be written per source file per architecture.
So it's actually not source specific, it's for the...
It's build specific.
Build specific. You have a BNMU, you have the same source.
Yeah, exactly.
You don't have
it's
the
build
same.
Specific.
Can you maybe show an example?
Yes, I'm trying to find. Yes.
But in the main.
Open it on another justified.
Make it a bit smaller so we can.
Can you open just the file? But without the frame or.
But that's it. That's really
it's good.
Is that an extended.changes file?
Yeah. I mean, something I've been pondering for a while is that for me, I'm switching from if this really makes sense to put into a different file or not. And
that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, but the changes files are not exposed on any interface. I mean, of course, we would have to have agglomeration of the things exposed in the repository, but.
So what we thought about these files. What we thought about these files, adding 200,000 files to the FTP server is a bad idea, because that's as many files as there are now for SID and Scratch, basically. So I tried to just cut them all together, and that reduced the size, so that made it one file half, and made it 140 megabyte, but I assume the file will even be smaller because half the packages are ARCH-all, or whatever percentage. And compress this 140 to a 14 megabyte compress.
Is that all files together or per architecture?
That's per architecture. But we would need these files per architecture, and I would also want these big files to be on the Mural network for the users, while these individual files, I think it would be enough if they would be an FTP master and maybe a snapshot. So that we can build a service built in for Debian org where users can download these files. The users will need to download these files to reproduce it.
Yeah,
putting
them directly in the dev file.
You cannot put them in the dev file because then you change the...
Right. Well, except if you get the MD5 of every component of the file, not the dev file.
It will also bloat the packages file because you get all the like dependencies.
Yeah,
it's pretty big. And
how big is the packages file now?
That's
huge.
Too big.
That hits every user.
So you have the data in the same kind of format as all the locale for the description files.
But that's what I would. Is one big
basically
that thing. The question is maybe whether we put this information really in the build info file in an extra file or put it in the arch changes file.
I think changes makes, I mean, because most of the stuff is just the same, so there's only.
You
want to
head this discussion?
My initial idea was that changes, and then I researched, and in the end, I thought it was a bad idea for several points. That changes file do not have a normalized name at all. You can upload anything that changes with some reference, and it will just go in. You can upload source-only packages, and they're accepted. So in the context of reproducible build, they don't have any binaries, so they don't make sense. And also for me, like dot changes they represent the transaction to the archive, where build info information that we want to keep forever. Associated with the actual binaries and the source. And the last point was that...
The last point I don't get.
Which one?
What is the last one? The transaction versus snapshot of the...
Well, it's well, maybe you don't care, but for me it was easier to reason that way. Anyway, in the last thing was that I want multiple people to be able to sign that file. And dot changes right now, they have an inline signature. And this is you can't have multiple signature with an inside signature. It's getting
it's actually not such a crazy idea to put the build info file inside the dev, because if the build environment changes, then we would expect the rest of the dev to change anyway.
You cannot hash the dev when you can hash the dev. But you don't need to put
the hash of the dev in the build info file. You can just hash the dev. You put the build info file without any reference to the dev itself inside the dev, and then anything that's about the dev you can just get.
And where do you collect the hash of the dev?
If you have
a hash in the changes file and the rest in the build info file, you need two files where you needed one before.
Yeah, so
that makes things more complicated to validate.
If you put the instead in the info file, you put the hash of the data.tar.xz and the control part.
Yeah, you can append.
Then your dev will be exactly the same file. You have the same hash, and you have the build info file inside. You share the same build info at least.
Yeah.
One tension for me is what kind of tool do you use at the end of the rebuild process to assess that you got the same information. And I believe that Chassons is easy enough. Anything more complicated, that means that you have to prove that more tools are actually correct, and that's...
You will have the same construction at the end. If it is different, you will have to look inside.
I think I can shed a bit light on this, just thinking for a different way. I think at the moment Luna is trying to reproduce the build info file, while other people just tend to think about reproducing the dev files. So maybe that connection should be split. I believe in build info files there's at least three problems. That's uploading the information, storing the information, and signing the information. And for at least my feeling would be that for uploading the information, in that case just the list of dependencies, not the checksums, whatever, would be the changes files, which is just a transport container for uploading the stuff. Then you need to think about how to store it, and then how to sign it is yet another question. But my feeling has always been that this build info file, it doesn't really fit into the way Debian is working at the moment. So maybe use the changes file as an upload container, and then store the information in a packages like file.
So wait a second. This build info for me, they will be listed in the dot changes and be uploaded to the archive as referenced in the dot changes. And also for the signature part, it is the same problem, because if I want to do a rebuild, I don't want to have to download the actual .dev from the archive. Just the build info file is enough.
What would happen is that you can even accept that you can upload new changes files signed, and then you can extract the signature and store it somewhere else. I mean, you don't need to keep the changes files.
Yeah, I don't want to keep the changes files.
Yeah, but my point is that if we end up agglomerating all the contents in a big, same way that we do, we have packages, we have changes or whatever, then you can store the signature somewhere else, so you don't have to. I mean, I kind of agree with what he's saying, that one thing is a container, and this changes file is just conveys information, and then we store it in the databases whatever way we want, and then it can be exposed in a single file.
As someone who did the initial build, I want to give to the world a proof and an assertion that this is what I got. So this is, I wanted the build info sign to be signed by multiple people, first by the developer, so I don't have to trust the archive, that the key from the archive is not compromised, and I can check initial keys one by one, and the keys I want, even like I can trust only a subset of Debian if I'd rather do it. This is why the use cases I had in mind. And so I don't want these signatures to be merged, eaten by the archive thingy. So I don't have to trust the archive key as my own, my trust root.
But that doesn't really work, so the only thing you are trusting in the future will be the build keys, which are completely automated.
No.
Because we are moving to having everything rebuilt by build keys, not by people.
Yes, but I want the maintainer to be able to also say, this is what I got. Okay. On top of the BLDs, this is the thing we can...
Ah, okay, you make it source only upload and have your build info file included.
Yes.
Okay.
We want people to be able to upload just the checksum and the sources.
Okay.
Doesn't that require that the build team rebuilds using exactly the same versions of packages that were used by the maintainer?
2017.
Let me give another reason for not including the build info into the Debian binary package. So if you think of reproducible builds more as a QA measure, then it would be interesting to know whether the package rebuilds to the exact same binary with slightly different build depends, or thinking further, if you swap out the build architecture. And for being able to do such a thing, one needs to have the build info not be in the Debian package. So that's a useful thing for future, and it would be cool if we wouldn't block that future right now.
So for that, in the case of putting the control data and the other thing, the hashes of those inside the build info file, that would still be able to admit your use case. In general, you wouldn't expect, if you change the build environment, for the output to be the same. Just sort of like philosophically speaking, the dev is the end result, and it's good for the end result to point to all of the context that was used to create it. So I don't see like any... So for the signatures case, instead of signing the build info file, you could just sign the hash of the dev, and then the dev itself would contain the build info file, so you're signing the same amount of information.
Yeah, but why not sign the build info directly?
Because then you have two files. You have the build info inside the dev. You just need to sign the hash of the dev.
Yeah, but I mean, I have to download that .dev to get the data to need. I need to reproduce it, which I think is downside and can't allow what we've just said. That is, upload the source and the build info and have it reproduced by the buildees and see if it matches.
I don't agree that this is a good solution to put the build info in the dev, like precisely for Helmut's reasons. But if we wanted that, DAC could extract this information on install time, because that's what it's been done for the control information anyway. So I mean, I don't think that's a valid reason not to do that. I think that there are other reasons not to do that. But
I'd like to use this session to not be only about the build info. So maybe you also should.
One mining question about the build info file.
Well, perhaps a small note you see from T-Shirt, so I can tell you a bit from OpenSUSE. Perhaps you heard we have the OpenPeed service, which reveals everything automatically if a peed defend changes. And for example, there are cases where, let's say, you fix a typo in a error message in library, so that won't change the packages that link to the library. So short version, I'd not put the build info in the package, because you can have different versions of the library and still get the same application that it's with.
I'm all for discovering other topics. But the only other relevant topic I see is this build pass thingy, and the rest, the step helper stuff is easy, source data, top, I think, is uncontroversial rather.
But
for this build info thingy, I would hear yours as well, but then how do we proceed with this? I would like to discuss how we move forward.
Just one minor comment, can you show the build info file again? Can you please not in 2015 deploy things that mention
I'm using just the dpkg library output, and it does that. I can remove it if
get
you want
rid
to,
of them everywhere.
It's
please.
It's
yeah, but what, I mean, it they don't hurt. I mean,
that is not true.
They hurt the brain.
Why? Because you never know which of these things clients actually verify.
Yes.
Yes, but you should verify all of them.
No. Throw away and they
verify. Why should you not verify all of them?
Because there's no way.
That's another discussion. Just there was one thing that I wasn't sure about, and this is related with what you just said, is that at some point I was wondering if instead of having version here, it would not be best to have hash, cryptographic hash of the package.
Yes, please.
It makes it easier to find it on snapshot. And also, if we, it means that we don't have to rebuild the package later if it's only a change of version. But right now we can't do that because we don't have the information stored in apps. GKG status library. So maybe this is something that we should discuss. That's a trade-off, but I like it.
Yeah, I think like it's
to me, it sounds good to replace the version with a hash of the whatever we decided to do.
Of the .dev installed.
Yeah.
Which role?
What you would have there is add user and then the SHA-256 or 5 club of the .dev of add user.
Yeah.
So you need to sort it when installing it.
I would like to complement the version by the hash.
Yes, whatever.
So the QA person and me would like to keep the version even though even if we are not using it.
Yeah. It is easier to reason also from a user point of view. I've also have a concern when it comes to the either enforcement or the what should we consider the container or the smallest unit of reproducibility, and I've mentioned this on the list, and I'm not entirely sure that using the binary package as the smallest unit makes sense because it makes life easier for everyone. But my concern is that it might disallow us or might paint us into a corner that we cannot get out of. So if we want to include like unreproducible things by design into dev packages like signatures, it disallows it. So
signatures are not a problem. We have this. You can make, if the build is reproducible and the developer signs the binary, you can detach the second signature and attach it later with every reproducible build, the signature will match.
Yeah, true.
So
signatures embedded into the binary, I guess is what he means.
Yeah, but he's saying that you could like have them outside and like black and yellow.
So we started to discuss this also lately because of Grub and Linux signatures, which in a few emails on the mailing survey.
Yeah.
But true, this is if we want to have signatures for the .dev as a role dot thing, we would have to, my thing was like adding a field to the build info that would set signature, and we just like at the end of the rebuild process copy paste it and see if the final hash match, and I think that would work. Does it make sense?
It makes sense. Well, I guess it shifts the like what's more difficult from one side to the other.
Mm-hmm.
So how do we move on with this build info package changes file? Where do we with this question?
So I personally find it hard to discuss. Just to give you a feeling, is that I've been like trying to fiddle with this thing for a couple like 6 or 7 months, and so everybody has to make the whole like process thought, you know. And this is a bit frustrating to me. So I'm totally up to discuss more, but maybe with smaller crowd, maybe 5 or 6 people, and we try to get to the bottom of a proposal. Maybe.
Do you have all of the points written down on the page somewhere?
Most of it is on the history page on the wiki, and
so
the rest is on my head, I guess. In the history page on the wiki, there's quite some points, and the rest is might be in my head. So.
I
mean, I was just, like, there's not so many notes, so, yeah.
I think there's not much in the history page. I think it's more on the lobby now.
Okay.
I read the history page 2 days ago, also.
So,
maybe we can dedicate 1 hour tomorrow of this whole session we have to that question.
Or two.
Yeah.
I mean, if we can leave that conf with having a concrete proposal that is fits for everybody, that would be... I mean,
this is
please,
the,
let's
the
do that.
Main blocker also for this R bug in D package.
Mm-hmm.
So then we have.
Okay, so what do we need? We need an FTP master or two, we need someone from D package, we need someone from you, we need what else?
Nothing. And we need,
I think that's it.
Nothing else, that's it. 3 teams and. Yeah.
Cool.
And the other question is the build pass question.
We have 15 minutes left.
Where to build the. packages.
So, and as an introduction for that, if we can get rid of the fixed build path requirement, I would be up for it. But we have no tool right now that is able to mangle, like at the post-processing step, dwarf and elf files to get rid of the path to the .c or .whatever file that is getting compiled. And right now, the best tool that exists is called Debug Edit. And sadly, since dwarf files contain now a hash table for the string, then you can use Debug Edit to replace the path that is in the hash table to other paths. But then the order is not correct from one build to the next, because hash table ordering, it will be different. Like, anyway, sorry, too much details. But yeah, I mean, we need someone to write elf code, like code to mangle health or dwarf, and this is not a problem anymore. But this was way beyond my skills and time.
But you also be way beyond anybody's skills who worked on this so far.
Actually, if we start building debugging packages automatically not on the maintainer machines, then in a way this kind of disappears, because most of this stuff is coming from debugging systems.
Well, they get embedded. What we do for Debian is we pass minus G and then we strip.
Yeah, but what I mean is that this gets recorded in the debugging symbols, and if they are built like somewhere else, then it's not a privacy leak anymore from the container point of view.
Yeah, I mean we can agree that to have a fixed location for everybody, that's also a way to solve it. But it's just to say that this is not it's a workaround already. And it's not the final solution.
As far as I know, the build is build in slash build or build D. Which one? Slash build. So if D package would only put the build info, the build path in the build info file, if the path is slash build D, I think the privacy concerns would be addressed.
No, but my point is that if we are going, I mean, if the helper starts emitting. But it builds them itself automatically, so yeah, it doesn't fix it.
So, this privacy leak was being fixed, but what I still dislike about the solution is that slash build D is not standardized, it's not part of the file hierarchy standard, and we want users to be able to rebuild the binaries, so that way we would force every user to violate against the file hierarchy standard and create slash build, which I think is kind of ugly.
Yeah. Do we have a better path? Or?
I would use whatever, TMP, build D, var, build D, whatever. So far, the build D maintainers were rather like, nah, we don't want to change this.
Well, the point about the build side is before we're mounting partitions there, now we have the wash routes, including the build partition and the same TMPFS. So I guess we can change the path without any problem, at least for all builds that have been upgraded to JC. And
just tell us what it should be, basically.
Yeah, I don't know what it should be. I mean, the point is that it's defined by SBuild currently. As long as we do a change in SBuild, I guess we can pick that for the builders, and any pass is fine as long as it looks same. But you have to pay attention is that right, historically, the pass was slash build, the name of the package and the version, and it has been changed for security issues for people, not from the builders, but for people using SBuild. So that the path is not predictable. So probably you don't want to change.
What are the security rules that are not predictable paths?
Temp raises.
Yeah, if you are using different users, if different users can use this build, then, and the build partition is shared, you can.
As long as we have a common prefix, I can key on that. I mean, if it's say SRB, build D, or
yeah,
I don't know.
The idea is to have the same on the buildings and on what user can
okay,
use.
So SBuild should use a separate mount namespace so they can't.
So, but for, let's say that for buildings, I don't think we are fine with any pass as long as it looks same. So you're going to build in slash lib, for example. Yeah, but if it is sane, I don't see any impact on this. And the best is to get the chain in S built, and then we'll deploy that on the build.
But it has to be always the same, otherwise we're not reproducible anymore.
Yeah, that's why I think the build is one of the things you need in there. It's probably finding a sane path that can be used by a user.
Okay.
Yeah.
Don't we need a fixed parse for debugging symbols anyway, so that the GDB can find the source again? Can't we just fix the problem at the same time? And I think the user source Debian I saw on the build info file on the web browser looked just right.
The idea was to use something like that.
Because it would just allow me to upget source the stuff to that location, and then GDP will just work.
Source Debian.
Yeah, but it's below the user hierarchy, which should be read only.
User local.
I don't know any other better proposal. So.
The only problem is that as a user it makes your life more difficult.
Isn't user source at the moment special anyway?
You need permissions to write that.
Can get these.
Yeah, of course. But maybe not all users can do that.
But any other location will have the same problem. So this is as good as anything else. And /TMP is not the right place to put it
at. I think slash /var would be better because then you really can have user read only module, and you don't need to go into the user local one, which I expect something to be for a local thing. Var source or no local. Var source or var build, whatever, but in var.
So which user can var can?
10 more minutes we have.
So what's the difference between using this and having it writable for every user and slash TMP?
TMP is bad because it tempers as it's small and it smells.
Well, maybe. But this should be vertical, and you still have five races about who creates the path. This is writable by every user.
And we don't have to discuss security issues, because any location will have the same problems. So we need to decide on a location,
the thing is that
fix the problems separately.
Before there was no security issue because the paths were randomly generated, and by using a fixed path, you create a security issue if the directory is shared.
You can still append some randomness.
No, you can't.
No,
you
can't. You cannot, because then you don't have a reproducible
build
anymore.
You want to reproduce the build.
And if you just you need a hard
For locally reproducing, I can do that, yes.
But I think maybe we have to lift that. In a multi-user system, not multiple users can reproduce binary.
Yes. Let's not spoil this by...
Isn't this solved by mount namespaces?
That's why.
You can just mount your own stuff over there and build there.
Find that whatever directory you want to use in
direction.
But we have said good for our users, our tools would need to support that completely.
Yes.
Okay. Also, what's wrong about mkdir and checking the owner?
Yeah.
Does mkdir follow some links?
No. It's still like it, right? Because I can't build at the same time as you build.
Bad luck. If it's reproducible, just wait for my result.
Good point.
Sorry, you can't fix everything at once.
Yeah.
No, but this is almost the same amount of work as just fixing the tool chain. I mean, understandably, all the stuff.
So does this sound right? Can we go for it?
It still feels wrong because this is an actual problem that should be fixed in the root, but punting it because it's too hard. I mean,
Maybe for this first look at the FHS, because the point of using slash build is not in FHS. I don't think var is in FHS. While US local is secretly used.
My current proposal was fix whatever the SBL or BLD has, like use TMP build, have this build path thing is the build info right now, and one day someone will come from heaven and give us a post-processing tool for Elf and Dwarf, and then we can get rid of that.
That doesn't solve the problem, because you have plenty of build systems that end up compiling
from actually paths, and then those paths get.
We can fix those. Most of them, when I did like the test 1 year and a half ago, I could fix. The only one that couldn't fix was the Offenbach.
Maybe it should not appear the first time in the generative file. The problem is that you want to post-process the file, and maybe it's more complicated than not putting the info when they are created.
But we need it.
You can always specify the source path on GDB, for example. So you, I mean, it's a convenience. I don't think it's a requirement. It's
yes, but you need it to be fixed.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
No, I mean fixed. You mean it needs to be embedded?
Yeah.
I don't think. I think it's convenient.
You can put the relative path.
I mean, if you can patch GCC. all the better, maybe. I don't know. It's just that for now, I couldn't find.
I don't know if it's easier or not, but maybe it's some way to some path to look at.
I'm quite sure OpenSUSE has a field check that complains if you have your field moved somewhere in your resulting RPM, so it should be possible. So I'd say maybe you should just talk to the OpenSUSE field service maintainer.
You're using debug edit to get to a canonical path.
Good question. I'm
not
that deep in the field service, so I tell you who can answer the question, but I can't answer it myself.
I've looked at it, at least for Fedora and OpenSUSE, they use debug edit, and then the compare script will just ignore this thing.
But isn't that coming from RPM itself?
Yes.
So that's why it's fixed, because RPM takes care of this by itself.
Yes.
So,
but we could use that in developer, GStrip, that would get the same thing, or we could patch GCC to not have this path information at the same at once. But I know it's going to piss off some developers because they like it.
But I mean, in the end, it's the same problem. If you as a user download the sources on your home, the path will match anyway. So I mean, people has had this problem for like.
Yes, but if I'm developing my own software, I do want GCC to just work.
Yeah, but you may want creative paths. It works.
Well, if you want.
For me, that's the ideal solution. If there's no path, then there's no problem at all.
Yeah.
You don't even have to care about standardizing.
Or relative
paths,
because it's useful in GDB. Yeah. So.
That's my ideal goal. I would love to work on this. Can we agree on just like have a fixed path for build D and S build, have the build path in the build info thing, and then we try to get rid of it in the near future? Does that sound reasonable? Isn't reasonable.
Yes, please.
I really want to get rid of it. But I do want reproducible builds to move forward before having to get fixes in GCC. We have to move on to the set. What else? There were some developer. Yeah, is it all right to have strict non-determinism as a build dependencies for, I don't know, 18,000 packages?
Just include it in dev helper?
Yeah. I'd rather not, because some other distributions might be interested in improving it. And
that
so we
make it a dependency.
Yeah, have the helper depend on that, so we don't need to.
I don't want to fix my package.
Yeah, that's that. No,
but it should be reusable.
So that's no. I'm asking because this is what we have in the test repository right now. We are not strict on determinism. It's a dependency of developer.
How many thousand packages does it add for stripping?
Just
very few. It's all already in a Perl. It depends on a few Perl modules, but they're all on architecture, all.
Okay.
Depends on Perl itself and libarchive zip Pro.
Sounds okay.
And
unless that pulls in zip and unra and whatnot.
Nice, it's deliberately done.
Yeah. We're very careful about dependencies that pulls in.
So I guess we are out of time for this roundtable. First thing, thank you for being here. Great progress already, and there's a couple of issues, but I'm pretty confident we get to the ground before the end of that one.
You can